everyone, and thank you for joining me for today's workout. It's gonna be a complete core workout, and we're gonna go for 10 minutes. Let's get started right away. So for the first exercise, we're gonna start on our backs, and we're gonna crunch up, meeting opposite leg and arm. We are staying on this side for the whole 30 seconds, and then we're swapping over to the other side. So the exercises that I've picked for today's workout are all gonna be very controlled, and it's not as much about speed as it is about keeping the right shape. It's time to switch sides, so now I'm gonna meet my left arm with my right leg. So next up we have a leg lift with a crunch at the top. So you want to bring your legs down as far as you can, and when you bring them back up, you also want to crunch with your upper body. We're doing the dead bug, and we're gonna keep the same arm and the same leg throughout the whole 30 seconds. What you want to think about here is to really elongate your body when you reach out. It's almost like you have a string attached to the tip of your fingers and to the toes that is pulling you apart and really making you stretch. Switching sides. Meet both of our legs in the tabletop position, and we're gonna go for a toe tap. So your legs are gonna be bent, and you're just gonna touch your toes to the floor and then bring them back up to the tabletop. From here we go straight into a roll-in, and we're gonna kick our legs up to the sky and then lower them into a leg lift. So I've had a few people coming to me saying that they don't really feel this exercise, and this might be because you're swinging yourself backwards and forward using momentum instead of actually engaging your core. My biggest advice for you then is that when you're in that kick-up position, try to lower yourself really slow and really controlled. This way, you're gonna feel how your core is working. So, we're going into a full sit-up, and we're gonna raise our right arm above our head while our left arm is staying straight out in front of us. Switching sides. We're gonna keep doing those full sit-ups, but when we reach the top, we're gonna add a twist. So you're gonna twist to your right and twist to your left, and then lower yourself down into the sit-up again. Remember to keep the tension in the abs when you twist. now we're going into a half sit-up, which is a little bit higher than a crunch, but not as high as a full sit-up. So you want to stop at the point where your abs are most engaged and then lower yourself down again. You should really start to feel the burn right about now. And we're moving into an alternating bicycle crunch with straight legs. Next up, I want you to come into a normal elbow plank position and we're gonna crunch here. Maybe I should tell you where I am today as well. This is actually by Tower Hill Station and it's right outside the Four Seasons Hotel. Right now, because it's lockdown, it is closed and thankfully there was no cars passing. We move into a high plank position and we're gonna rotate our body to the right, really engaging those obliques. I want you to perform this movement really controlled, and every time that you come down into the high plank position again, you can take a second to reset before you lift that right arm up again. Switching sides. Side plank and we're adding a leg lift. If this feels a little bit too hard, you can also just stay in a side plank hold, or you can go down on your knee standing in a side plank hold. This shouldn't come as a surprise, we are switching sides. You can come back into an elbow plank position and we're gonna do some hip dips. The last two exercises, guys, stay with me. We're moving into a high plank and we're gonna do twisting mountain climbers. I want you to do these really slow and really controlled to really contract all of that tension that will build up in our obliques and our entire core. For the last exercise, we meet again in an elbow plank and we're just gonna hold it here for the last 30 seconds and then we're done. Have some water, have some rest. You deserve it. If you like this video, give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Also, let me know in the comments below what you thought about the workout, if there's anything that you loved or anything that you hated. And I'll see you next time. Ciao!